Tonight, our Stations of the Cross will be based on reflections of everyday stories of our parishioners. For the past 3 weeks, we have been walking in the footsteps of Jesus on his journey to Calvary through his various perspectives. Our parishioners will now share their own perspectives of the Stations of the Cross in their own words. Following along with our liturgical theme, all together on our journeys to Emmaus. The invitation was sent to parishioners to pick a station of the cross and reflect on it based on their own journey to Emmaus, their personal peer encounter with Christ. Tonight, we will be hearing from 14 parishioners sharing with us their testimony, witness, reflections, and prayers on the Stations of the Cross. And they invite us to testify, witness, reflect, and pray with them. Let us begin our time of prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, source of our all life and hope, your Son Jesus called each of us to leave everything behind, deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow him. Guide each of us through the Holy Spirit to walk alongside your Son on his journey to Calvary, through our journeys to Emmaus. May we encounter him, get to know your love, and live our lives encountering him endlessly. We pray for our newborns, our children, our youth, our young adults, our parents, grandparents, godparents, and friends that on their road to Emmaus, they may see you, walk with you, and recognize you. We ask it through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Made the cross lighter and the burden bearable. Yes, my eyes are open to Jesus' teaching. My yoke is easy and my burden light. Let us pray.
Lord,
was difficult, but successful after a long recovery. Father Peter reminds me of Jesus bearing his own cross. And then he said to me, "It is not Roman for you to bear your own cross." Jesus' words. If any man would come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. Oh, pray. Lord,
thank you. Christ, and we praise you. Jesus falling along his way to the cross reminds me of my mother's journey of depression. Not only her walk, but my walk also. What a burden for the both of us. But it showed us what Jesus went through. We prayed and asked Jesus to help us. Along the way, Mother fell and broke her hip. Little did we know it was Jesus healing for the both of us. She recovered from both ailments, and I had a peace of mind again. Jesus has strengthened me through all of this. Troubles happen, and Jesus is always there to help us if we only ask. Let us pray. We pray for continued help and remind you of asking Jesus for any and every burden that comes along the road to
Thank you. fifth station, Simon of Cyrene helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Even though compelled, Simon of Cyrene helped Jesus succeed in performing the spiritual mission to guarantee our salvation through his crucifixion. I feel closest to God when I can help another without conditions or the expectation of reciprocity. Helping one who needs it reflects the love that Christianity is based on and is in accordance with what St. Paul teaches. Bear one another's burdens, and so you will fulfill the law of Christ. Let us pray. Lord, see the sacrifices to be servants to the brothers who need our help, offering our time and effort to them on salvation. Let us always remember the behavior of our Lord Jesus, who is our selfless, suffering servant.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. In September of 2008, we were expecting the birth of our fifth grandchild, Abigail. The daughter of my son and my daughter-in-law. All seemed well, but she was born with severe birth defects, and she went to be with God at about the age of 2 months. We turned to God's grace and to each other to get through this tragedy. 8 years later, in January of 2016, tragedy came again when my daughter miscarried at 37 weeks. There was no medical explanation for Austin's loss. Talk about being brought to your knees a second time. Of course, the question was, God, why? Comfort came to me by turning to Jesus and asking Jesus to help for our family and for myself to carry this cross. I could not have done it without him and without his help. I found peace and comfort knowing that through his sacrifice for us, his death, his resurrection, and his willingness to carry his cross for us, that we could join our sufferings to his and find strength to go on. I know that Abigail and Austin are in the loving arms of God in heaven, and I know we will see them again and share that love one day in the presence of God. Let us pray. Oh God, we pray for our children, our loving relationships, our family and family, and that we keep them around the world. As we watch them fall down to death, please be present whenever we can have theater for them. Patient as all, and make them up again and again, as you picture yourself as we fill the death of our hearts. That was a moment of confidence.
It has also been very rainy these last few weeks, and as usual, I never remember an umbrella at dismissal. On one very rainy dismissal day, a student of mine took her umbrella and put it over my head. Yes, it was pouring, and in the midst of the rain that was landing on her, she decided her teacher needed to not get wet and didn't think about herself. She suffered through the raindrops in order to keep me dry. Sometimes when we are suffering, we are wrapped up in our own pain and anxiety and don't realize that people beside us are hurting too. But she did on this rainy day. She gave me her umbrella. Can we be like this student and turn from our own way of the cross to comfort them? Let us pray. O God, help us to see others the way your Son saw them in Jerusalem. May our eyes see those who are suffering, who are in need, and are in need of your grace, so that we can meet them and say, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves. We pray for all teachers, educators, and all students. In their academic work, help them to learn to be selfless and see the needs of others before their own. Keep all children safe, innocent, and in their heart. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the soul of Father Govins and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. To give me the faith and strength to take his hand and carry my cross as he carries his. I reflect on Jesus' journey and sacrifice for us that our sins would be forgiven, and we might one day obtain eternal life and finally come face to face with our God. The decision to take his hand and walk with him is not a difficult one. It is what I want to do and where I want to be, always beside him and always helping him carry his cross and mine as he has done. Let us pray.
Among his executioners, and they will cast lots for his tomb. The shame and embarrassment of all this added to the physical and emotional pain Jesus had already endured on his way to the cross. And there was more pain to come. Jesus emptied himself entirely for us. He exposed himself for us to save us. On the road through life, we all suffer indignities. We all feel shame and embarrassment at some time. Jesus understands that experience completely. He joined us in our shame and indignities. And because he did, we can encounter him on the road to Emmaus. We encounter the risen Lord who knows us in all our highest points and all our lowest points. He offers us comfort and nourishment in the breaking of the bread. Jesus shows us that even in our shame, we are sons and daughters of God through him. Nothing can take that dignity away. Let us pray. Forgive us, Lord, for being an irreverent mob, prying into people's lives. Forgive us for being consumers of gossip under the name of news. Let us never expose anyone. May we respect the dignity of others and leave judgment to God. Let us see the good in those around us and so enable them to reach their full potential. Help us always to look for you in your Holy Scripture, in the people we meet, and in the breaking of the bread. In Christ our Lord, amen.
Crucifixion. crucifixion, Jesus was humiliated, shamed, brutalized. Then pain stretched his heart to a great depth of empathy and forgiveness that we have yet to fully understand. Our experiences of powerlessness, from which we were unable to protect ourselves, abuse we could not defend ourselves from, failings of our body or mind that have left us vulnerable, made us all at times feel hung up publicly and humiliated. Humiliation can make us deep in character, understanding, graciousness, and forgiveness, but can also make us angry, bitter, callous, and vengeful. How we handle those wounds will impact the rest of our lives. Let us pray. May God give us the grace to always resemble our betrothed, to forgive and forgive those who have forgiven, to unconditionally give and give love back, to unite our suffering with the suffering of Christ, and may be offered up for those who fail to take up their crosses or drag them behind and wear this content.
Jesus,
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. I came with the group of four women who stood at the foot of the cross. For as life goes on through me, I also stood at the foot of the cross. Grace, my mother, father, brother, sister, husband, and two sons. But God has been good to me. He has left me with eight living children right now, grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Life has been good, not always easy, but good. Then along came the coronavirus. We closed down the churches. We were left alone while being quarantined in our own home. Again, God was good. I was able to attend Mass every day at EWTN. However, no communion was available. Again, God was good as St. Elizabeth Seton Church attempted a soft opening of the church with very limited parishioners. A friend listed me on the computer so that I could attend Mass. After Jesus dying on the cross for me, how can I not hear a cross and know he has not died in vain? For in you, my God, I have found my home. Let us pray.
Testimonies, reflections, and prayers of our parishioners, reveal to us your love, mercy, and compassion on our own individual and our own individual journeys to Emmaus. Help us to never give up hope when everything around us falls to pieces. Help us to get back up whenever we fall and are ready to give up. And help us to look beyond our struggles and see the promises fulfilled by your Son, that his resurrection has defeated death and sin. Pray for us, walk with us, and we ask you through Christ your Son. Amen. As we end our time together, let us pray the prayer of the road to Emmaus. Be with us, Lord Jesus, on our road to Emmaus. Guide us on our journey and nourish us as we continue to walk in your light. Open our eyes that we may see your presence among us. Open our hearts that we may reflect your love, and empower each of us in our whole parish to echo the truth that is found in you alone. We ask it through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Once again for joining us to pray the Stations of the Cross on the road to Emmaus. I would like to thank, first of all, the parishioners who wrote beautiful reflections, testimonies, and prayers to testify their encounter with Christ on the road to Emmaus. And at the same time, I would like to thank Mary Blandon for encouraging them to write and reflect on the Stations of the Cross. Now, I invite everybody to take their booklet home with you. Do not give it back to us, but take it home with you. If you notice throughout our prayer, there is a lot of empty pages in the book, and that was left intended for you to write your own reflections, prayers, and witnesses on your road to Emmaus. Even though you were not able to come up and share your individual reflections, you will have the opportunity to do that in your own personal prayer time. So I invite everyone to do that as you return home and you reflect in your week and you finish off this Lenten journey and we go on our journeys beyond Lent and Easter. So thank you everybody for joining us tonight. May God bless you all. Have a safe journey home. That's pretty much it. So, good night, everybody.